In this video, I am going to explain few causes that create frozen shoulder. Frozen shoulder is that you cannot move shoulder joint. When you move shoulder, there's pain, right? In Japanese language, frozen shoulder is called 50s shoulder. 50s shoulder because many middle-aged people tend to have frozen shoulder, right? This symptom is called periarthritis. Periarthritis. Peri means around. Arthritis means inflammation in joint. So, frozen shoulder, there's inflammation around shoulder joint. Many cases of frozen shoulder is idiopathic. Idiopathic means the cause is unknown. The cause is from nowhere. But is that really from nowhere? Yes, they are from somewhere. They are from somewhere over the rainbow. So I will talk about what things can create frozen shoulder. So I want to focus on two muscle groups. First muscle groups is shoulder girdle muscle. Shoulder girdle muscles. These muscles actually do not cross shoulder joint. These muscles attach to scapula, ribcage, and spines. Okay, but these guys are so important. Let's say this muscle, this is pectoralis minor. Pectoralis minor, also known as pec minor. Let me explain one more muscle. That is this guy. This is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior. These two guys are freaking important for movement and stability of scapula. Okay? They are important for scapula. How come these guys affect frozen shoulder? Because, as I said, they do not cross shoulder joint. How come these guys can create shoulder pain? Okay, these guys attach to scapula again, okay? When scapula doesn't move, your shoulder doesn't move, okay? When pectoralis minor or serratus anterior get tight, your scapula does not move. When your scapula does not move, your shoulder cannot move. Thus, flexibility of shoulder girdle muscles is crucial for shoulder movement. Of course, there is other shoulder girdle muscles, such as this one. It's a little bit hard to see. This is trapezius. This is also important for scapular movement. It's very famous for a stiff shoulder around this area, right? That is because trapezius is very, very tight. That can create tightness around here. And also, if your trapezius is tight, that inhibits movement of scapula. That can create immobility of shoulder joint. What happens if your joint doesn't move for long period? Your joint doesn't move. It's like your car. If you do not drive car for a long time, your car doesn't move, right? It's same thing for human body. When your joint hasn't moved for a long period of time, your joint doesn't move. It's simple enough, right? Then there can be pain when you move. This is one cause for a frozen shoulder. Sometimes tightness of shoulder girdle muscles is involved for frozen shoulder. Let's go to next muscle groups. This is profile view of shoulder, and humerus is removed. So you are looking shoulder joint from lateral view. I want to focus on rotator cuff. Rotator cuff. There are four rotator cuff muscles, right? This is supraspinatus. Supraspinatus. This one is infraspinatus. This one is teres minor. And last one. This guy is subscapularis. Subscapularis. These four muscles together, it is rotator cuff. Imagine, there is head of humerus like this. Rotator cuff is like literally cuff of shoulder joint. It's very close to joint. Thus, when one of them gets tight, or few of them, all of them get tight, that can aggravate shoulder joint. Can you imagine that? Imagine there is humerus. Then let's say if your supraspinatus is very, very tight, don't you think that affects shoulder joint? Because these guys are literally close to shoulder joint. Same for infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis. When these guys get tight, that affect shoulder joint, okay? Rotator cuff is very, very important. Let me explain one more muscle. You know what this is? This is biceps brachii. Biceps brachii, particularly long head. This muscle is from superior part of scapula, and it kind of penetrates in shoulder joint, then it goes to elbow. Biceps actually can move shoulder joint, and I want you to focus on this part. I said tendon of biceps brachii penetrates shoulder joint. Oh my gosh, what happens if your biceps gets tight? Maybe that affects tension of shoulder joint. Then what's gonna happen? If your shoulder doesn't move for a long period of time, your shoulder doesn't move, literally, right? So biceps can be one cause for frozen shoulder. Of course, other muscles can be a cause for frozen shoulder. However, I think biceps is kind of hidden key for frozen shoulder because not many people focus on this part. Okay, this is important part. So in this video, I explained two muscle groups plus biceps. First group was shoulder girdle muscles, right? They do not cross shoulder joint. They attach to scapula. But movement of scapula is crucial to accomplish movement of shoulder. So when they don't move, shoulder doesn't move. When shoulder doesn't move, that may create pain. Next group was rotator cuff, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis. They are literally close to shoulder joint. So when they get tight, of course, they inhibit movement of shoulder joint. Last one was biceps brachii. This muscle is important for shoulder joint. There are other reasons that can create frozen shoulder, of course. But today's muscles are most likely involved for frozen shoulder. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.